The Justin Robert Young Show, brought to you as always by JuRY Daily. Did I not say .com? PayJuryDaily.com. That's where you need to go. Hi, friends. It is the August 15th, 2018 edition of the JuRY Daily Show. Friends, Romans, countrymen, let me your ears. War is upon us. Now it's not upon us for all of us. I'm saying it's a war is upon us for some of us, specifically everybody that's here in the U.S. of A. Yes, we're at war. Many of you guys haven't opened your eyes to it, but folks, we are at odds with a foreign nemesis. Yeah, a foreign nemesis, and we're gonna beat them. You want to know what we beat the Germans in World War One, right? We beat the Germans again in World War Two. We beat the British to win our freedom, and goddammit, we're not going to let these cheese weasels get their way. No. We are America, and we will succeed, and goddammit, we will win against the Danes. Yes, the Danes. Now, this is not going to be a war fought with conventional weapons. No guns, no mortars. We're not here for some sort of computer trickery whereby we're going to spear fish and hack and check to make sure the sockets are in dates. No. We're not going to try and interfere in their elections. We're not going to even attempt to depose their leaders. We're going to fight this battle with a weapon that every man has in their hands. Yeah. Sometimes two, maybe even three times a day, if you're a real patriot. Folks, we're in a sperm war. Yes, this from The Guardian. American and Danish companies are battling to dominate the global sperm market, and both claim that their supply is the biggest. So this is a story about apparently how in globally, if you want to get pregnant with some sperm because of a unique combination of laws and ethics and bio legalities in terms of trading and selling, both America and I keep saying the Dane because they keep saying a Danish company. I'm bad. What is it? All right. So when I say Denmark, that's it. All right. Something's rotten in the state of Denmark, and it's that stank sperm of y'all's. Demand for U.S. sperm is on the rise, writes The Guardian. Not just American, Danish sperm is also used by women around the world. The reason are as varied and distinctive as each country's own regulations and approach to bioethics and business. Sperm from the U.S. and Denmark dominate the market because those countries currently have the most supply. It's unclear whether the rivalry is serious or in jest. I'm here to say it ain't no joke. This is a fucking fight, Denmark. You want to bring some shit? You want to bring some cum? Fucking, I'll show you cum like you never seen, motherfucker. The U.S.-based California Cryobank and Denmark's Cryos International each insist that their sperm repository is the biggest. California Cryobank claims it's the largest sperm bank in the world by any metric. Scott Brown, director of client experience, noted that the firm has a pool of roughly 600 donors and track a record of 75,000 live births globally since 1977. The company has locations in Palo Alto, Los Angeles, Cambridge, Massachusetts, and New York. But in Denmark, the villainous Cryos, the superstore for Viking sperm, is the main player. Quote Corey Burke, the tissue bank director at Cryos International's Florida outpost, California Cryobank is definitely the largest in the United States. It's not only the definitely the largest in the United States, but worldwide. We absolutely crush them. So he's saying both domestic and abroad. Burke goes on, in Europe alone, we have close to 1,400 active and real donors. In the U.S., around 200 donors. We sell to over 100 countries worldwide. We own Europe. If you want sperm in Europe, Cryos always comes up. Cryos says in their email signature that they have the highest number of registered pregnancies in the world. I don't see a number on that, though. We had 77,000 here. Sorry, 75,000 from California Cryobank. What the fuck is this? We're tracking the largest number of registered pregnancies. Meh, specious. I don't buy it. About 90% of Danish sperms goes to other EU countries. Good, keep it. Says Carlsbad University Sebastian Moore, who wrote a book on Danish sperm banks. One reason the U.S. and Denmark are the heaviest hitters in the global sperm market is laws that allow for anonymity to donors, says Io Wahlberg. But wait, oh shit, you guys. Fuck, we're going to lose our way. We're going to lose our way. This is awful. Listen to this awful news. Hold on. California Cryobank changed its policy this year to take only non-anonymous donations going forward. Historically, heterosexual couples have tended to favor anonymous donations and offspring whose physical resemblance wouldn't give rise to questions about paternity. However, with lesbians and single mothers, most of the use of a donor is obvious, and clients and their children tend to be curious about their background. California Cryobank says, the concept of being an anonymous donor now is pretty hard to control with services like 23andMe and Ancestry. Suggesting that a donor could remain anonymous seemed like it was not realistic. I don't know. I don't like that. No, make it anonymous. Look, folks, we're in a war. I want to suspend these civilian era sensibilities where people are like, I want to know who my dad is. Sorry, kid. We all have to sacrifice a little something to beat back the Danes. We will fire shot after shot of our sperm supremacy at them until they realize who's boss. And one day they will wave the white flag. It might be a moist towelette to wipe their face, but they will wave that white flag. And we, USA number one, will be the king of cum. King of cum. USA, king of cum. USA. That's the dream that I believe in. That's the America that I know. And that's why I'm taking this opportunity to announce that indeed I am running for president of the United States. I am a single issue candidate. We will beat the Danes in the cum war. We will be kingdom come.
I don't know why I found all that so funny.
It is kind of a fascinating thing that you have to wonder as this market continues to get bigger, whether or not, like, are we, like, is this kind of insidious? Like, are we spreading Americans, partly Americans? Are we just, like dandelions blown out into the global community for every single mother and gay couple?
A lesbian couple, I guess. It's pretty awesome. I just like anything that the USA is number one at. And this image, this art is pretty cool. Look at that. American babies being delivered all over the world. By the way, where were you at, UK? Oh, shooting blanks, are you? Okay, sure, sure. Letting the Danes do your fucking dirty work over there. Rest of the world. We're coming at a high level. Olympic level come. Dedicated. Motivated. Ejaculated. All over the world. Let's go ahead and get to your emails. PD wrote about our mayonnaise experience. I generally am a fan of mayonnaise. I like it on a sandwich. It's a good plain oil-based dressing. Insert Stephen A. Smith. However, this old white bitch's article might have single-handedly turned me off mayo forever. Fuck this article and everything it stands for, including its boomer bait racism and internalized misogyny. Your potato salad sucks, Sandy. It sucks is almost as bad as your writing. Pa-pow. Strong, strong takes from Petey. Frozen Summers writes, as your mortal enemy and mayonnaise lover, even I have to agree with you, this article was horrid, overly florid, a piece of trash masquerading as a proper feature. I also agree that if something is on a sandwich like mayo or the pride of my homeland, Vegemite, it should be listed on the menu. All that being said, I'll just be here down under eating mayo and Vegemite from the jar with a spoon, but not at the same time. That would be weird. Well, at least you found some kind of boundary for yourself, Frozen Summer. Because I was starting to get worried. Nathan writes, come for the jury hating on mayo. Stay for the whitest article I've ever heard complaining about someone who won't eat her shitty macaroni salad. That is an absolute fact. But it pales in comparison to this video and sound that I will show you right now. Ladies and gentlemen, this came from the great Anthony Colangelo of Philadelphia. He sent this along yesterday. Please enjoy.
Hey, Jerry, I just walked out of this Whole Foods right behind me on South Street here in Philadelphia, as you can see behind me, and bought myself a copy of Philadelphia Magazine, where on page 56, the white stuff is here. So I thought we'd do a segment called Throw Out Your Mayo and keep up with the Scottish.
All right, wait, and just for everybody who didn't watch yesterday, the white stuff is the magazine version of the article that we read yesterday in Philadelphia Magazine.
Tradition that started last week. So I thought we would find ourselves at this nice little city playground and throw this guy right into the trash receptacle of Philadelphia. Throw out your mayo, peeps.
Boom! There we go, ladies and gentlemen. I love that he referred to it as the grand Scottish tradition. The Scottish tradition, of course, begun when one of our great listeners went to the ice cream parlor with mayonnaise ice cream, bought it, and then immediately walked out and threw it out. Now we have a trend. We have a trend where if you don't like something, you buy it and immediately record yourself throwing it away. I love this. I will play all the best videos that get sent doing this. I'm very excited that the Jury Daily Show officially has its first meme. Yes, we got our first meme. I'm so excited. I'm so pumped. In fact, I think I'm so excited that we might need to calm things down a little bit with a segment that we do every Wednesday called High Thoughts. Thank you.
anarchist jails
for me.
Right, Joe.
Traffic lights are really just the cops
of lamps. With a rock.
Buy a Perone in a store right now. Billboards are just the OG.
Pop-up ads. People with a foot fetish.
Ladies and gentlemen, you guys came fucking strong. You guys came strong on High Thoughts this week. We have so many High Thoughts. Those were only some of the best. But I told y'all that y'all needed to bring it. Y'all needed to write in High Thoughts or else the segment wasn't going to keep going. And holy shit, did you guys this week blaze your way to glory. Go ahead if you have any High Thoughts at any time. Again, High Thoughts. Just go ahead and send me the thoughts as they happen. JuryDaily@gmail.com. Put High Thoughts in the subject line. I want to thank our producers, The Gen, PD Rave, Kim Immel, Rock and Roll Martian. Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat is Justin R. Young. I want to remind you guys that Action News, my brand new game, available right now, actionnewsgame.com. Also, if you have my other game, The Contender, and you like it, do me a favor, go to Amazon, search for The Contender game, and review it. We're in a situation now, a very important time, where new reviews matter a lot. If you could take 5 seconds out of your day to do it, it'd be greatly appreciated. Folks, until tomorrow, my name's Justin Robert Young. I'm reminding you to please don't.
you have enjoyed this program.